Hi guys, this is me again, Dr. Zina, and welcome in here. Today, I am going to talk about another topic, which is root canal treatment. If your dentist told you that you need a root canal treatment, well, you're not the only one. There are millions of cases that are treated every day, trying to save the tooth to stay healthy in your mouth. So what is the root canal treatment? Why it's done? I have talked previously about the tooth structure and what are the layers that makes up the tooth. We said, if you remember, if you were following my shows, the first layer is called the enamel. Then we have the second layer, which is the dentin. Then the third layer, which is the inside of your tooth, which is the pulp. If you have a cavity that you haven't been treated, you've been ignoring the signs that you're having, and you're in pain, but you're not listening to what you're going through. You never saw a dentist before. It means you have got your infection got to inside of the pulp. It means we need to trying our best to save this tooth. So what is the root canal treatment? It's the removal of the infected tissue, which is inside your tooth. Kind of frustrating that you keep on going to the dentist between now and then. For you, of course, for us, it's normal for the first and second, and you keep on nagging and ignoring, well, I don't like dentists. This is not really nice experience that I'm going through to have a root canal treatment. Here I am trying to explain to you what do we do and how we're trying our best and what is the best quality that you can get of saving this tooth. First of all, we need to remove this pulp. So your tooth is infected. We need to prepare an access to the tooth. So there is a picture. You can just, how can I get an access to the cavity? So how can I do this? By using the Mr. B, I used to call it. So we need to use this. I drill. I need to place a tip here. I'm just demonstrating, so I'm not really using it. But we place a tip, then we try to drill in your tooth, trying to get an access to get into the pulp. So once we have removed the damaged tissue, we get an access to the pulp. So there's a picture. Then the second step of that, if we can just locate the access of these canals, it depends on the tooth, which tooth you want to treat. The anterior ones, the ones in the front or in the back, the number of root canals is different according to the tooth, to the tooth type. So we have to locate an access for the root canals. This is very important because if I have missed one canal, the treatment will be failed. So I need to make sure that I get a proper access to all the canals. Some canals are so small and so hard to be detected, so I need to be very specific, and you have to help me with that. So you stop, keep on nagging and closing your mouth so I can see a clear vision, so I can locate the canals. So now we have got an access and we have located the entrance for the canals, and we have located the numbers and counted the numbers of canals that you have. Now we have to measure the length of this canal. So there's an image that shows you how can I determine the length of this canal. My goal is to get an accurate numbers, exact same numbers. Maybe some studies shows like it has to be right on the apex, which is on the end of the canal, or just half 0.5 millimeters away from the apex. Why do I need this? Because if I could get my tools to exceed more than the actual length or less than the length, the treatment will be failed. How can I locate this canal, the length of the canal? Well, there are two ways. Whether number one, by using the x-ray. We have, after we have opened the tooth, we have to locate a file. This is called a file. So don't be surprised when you see, it depends. At the beginning, we need to use this file, the smallest size. I have to place it inside the tooth. Then I take an x-ray to see if I have got the whole length of the root canal. So we have, whether on the x-ray or we use this device, which is called the apex locator, I am going to place this inside the tooth canal, the root canal, and then it's going to show me a reading on the screen in here. Then am I hitting the apex or am I away from the apex? So this is the second way of measuring the actual length. I have to take I have to be really accurate sometimes. I need, you should tell me, I don't give you anesthesia, and then you should tell me if you're feeling any pain, then it just can give me some clue and indicators that I am close to the apex. I told you, I don't know, I don't want to exceed the root canal treatment, the root canal length, because if I exceed it, I might irritate the ligament. The ligament is just, let's say like a belt that connects your tooth to the underlying jaw. If I could hit this, it might cause post-operative pain. You might go back home and you go in pain, so you should be really helpful, and you just tell me whenever you feel in pain or discomfort, so I need to know. So now I'm done with this step. I have located the length of the root. Then the fourth step, which is now I need to shape and to remove all the infected pulp. How can I do it? I can do it by using whether manual technique or by a machine, it depends. I am not going to go in details because there are so many ways, so many techniques. I am just going to tell you how can I get this done. Some doctors, they prefer to do it manually. I need to use these files, just use them. It's just like trimming, you know? I need to get them inside your root canal and I treat and remove all the infected tissue all around the root canal. So, of course, because I am trimming, just like when you trim your nails, and and then there is like this powder debris that remains. So we don't want it to stay in here because it might block the canal. So in this case, I need to keep on irrigating. What is irrigation? It's use of special types of liquid, water, and special chemicals added to it to keep on. There's a picture of it. We just can show you how it works. I can irrigate or keep on washing these canals to make sure all the bacteria, all this infected tissues will be removed out of your tooth. So you will have a clean tooth. Then I will keep on, it's called like reaming and filing. I keep on using this until I will get to the shape and the size that I'm looking for. I'm done with this step. I am sure now there's nothing, no infected tissue still in your pulp. Now I have to dry it up to make sure there's no bacteria left, and I will place my filling. The filling that I am going to place is not the regular filling that you used to get when you have not a root canal treatment. So I prefer, every doctor has their own way, but my way is just when I finish the root canal treatment, I prefer to put a temporary filling and take another x-ray to make sure that I have really sealed the canal and there is no access, there is no shorten in the filling, so the tooth is in sound and safe state. Then I put the temporary filling for 2 days. If you have any discomfort, you're not. This temporary filling that I'm going to use, it's really good in protecting my work, so no germs, no bacteria from your mouth can get inside and destroy what I've done. 2 days, 3 days, then you will get used to it. Just tell me if there's anything, any discomfort that you have. I will make sure, take an x-ray, make sure that the root canal is really well done. Then I have to place the permanent filling. The permanent filling, I have to choose it according to the state of your tooth. If the tooth is really damaged, the use of filling is not going to make any benefits, because especially if it's like the teeth in the back of your mouth, when you chew them, you might break them. So in this case, if it's really damaged, not a lot of tissue remains, not in the root, I'm talking about the crown, like the tooth that's visible in your mouth. In this case, I need to place a crown, and there's a picture of a crown that we have to take an impression, send it to the lab, and they're just going to modulize a tooth that can be fit in the destructed tooth. Or if the tooth is sound and it couldn't remove a lot, I could save a lot of the tooth tissue, then in this case, I will put a regular filling, and then your root canal treatment is done. I wanted to talk about this because most of the people have experienced this, that because you're not really brushing and flossing the way it should be. So I always say prevention is way better than a cure. So always don't forget to brush and to floss, use the mouthwash so you can save your life a lot of money and you can save a lot of time in protecting your tooth. So that was for today. I hope I was beneficial. Thanks a lot for watching, and please stay tuned for more and more health information.